So this is Bob Kraft of tennisministry.org, and we're talking about Chinese tennis players, Chinese system here. I've been associated with this environment for the last 20, 25 years almost, and so I know what's happening. And I'd like to talk right now about the current players and how the ministry has been able to reach out to them. As I mentioned, I've been sharing the gospel since 1992, full-time with the Chinese players as I would see them. Right now, let's go back a little bit to, I've got my notes here because there are quite a few players I want to talk about. Lina won the French Open last week. Actually, I met her and I saw her in the 2006 Wimbledon Championship. She made it to the quarterfinals. What was surprising to me was she was practicing with two coaches that I had known for years, Chinese coaches, the national coaches, and I had also been sharing the gospel with. God opened that door. It was very unusual because I knew all the national players of China, and I'd been sharing the gospel with them, but I didn't know her. She hadn't been around, and so it was surprising to me. The reason they allowed her to come in and practice with the national team, because there was a split between the national players and the players that weren't on the national team, and she was not working with them on the national team. So, but the reason they practiced with her was because the coach, the men coach and the woman coach had actually grown up with her, and they knew her, and they'd worked with her when she was a kid. And on top of that, she was in the quarterfinals of Wimbledon. So Na Li was with them on the court, and she was playing out points with them, practicing and so forth. I was sitting there watching it. Then the second thing was that I didn't know her. I didn't see her very much. Again, as I would meet all the Chinese players, I'd share the gospel by giving them tracts and pamphlets and simplified Chinese Christian materials. And I'd give them crosses and I'd pray with them. And that's the best I could do. We had a language barrier. And then Na Li, over a period of years, she was always, she'd smile at me when she'd see me. But I wasn't really focused on her. I was more with the national players. Just because I'd known them and it was easier for me to reach them. Na Li ended up getting married, and her husband, from that moment on, she changed quite a lot, because before she was very approachable and she was easy to talk to for me and for other people. But all of a sudden she was sitting with her husband, and her husband really wouldn't want people to come around and talk to her. He would, from my standpoint, when I would go up, he would actually not be that friendly, and he would stop as best he could any conversation. And then there was other people I saw similar. So there was definite change there. And of course I wish them the best as a married couple, but for the French Open, he was taken away as her coach. He'd been a pretty good player in China himself, and she changed to a coach from Denmark. So I don't know all the situation there with the marital situation, but I do know that's what happened. And we need to pray for Na Li, because I tried my best to reach out to her and the other players, and for sure I was able to reach all the players who surround her, the Chinese players, but I wasn't able to really effectively reach her. So let's pray for her, and that's the situation with Li Na. Now, I mentioned earlier about Peng Shuai. I met her on the tour in her early days. I've shared the gospel with her. I've given her materials. I prayed with her. Her mother has been at various tournaments. She worked briefly with Michael Chang, and Michael Chang tried to share the gospel with her. He gave her material because Michael told me that, and I was also sitting with Peng Shuai talking to her about it. I watched the Jesus movie with her and let her see some movies on the Olympics and Christians who were in the Olympics. And you know, that's the best I can do. But she's always been a little bit standoffish. I haven't been super close to her, just because she's always been a little bit like a rebel outside of the system. And she doesn't really build super close relationships with people unless she has a really good reason to. So that's Peng Shuai, and her ranking right now is 25. Then we have the next player, Zhang Shuai. I don't know her. She's ranked 76 now this week. I don't know her. She's a new player who's come on the tour, and let's pray for her. The next one is Zhang Ji. Zhang Ji is someone who's been very friendly to me and been very open for many years. I've been able to share the gospel with her. In the very beginning stages, she didn't really speak English, so I wasn't able to talk to her much, but her English improved to where it's almost flawless now, and I've been able to give her materials through the years. Let's keep lifting her up in prayer. Her ranking is number 80 now. This week she's dropped 33 spots, so she's struggling as a player. She's one of the top doubles players, having won Wimbledon and the Australian Open doubles with her partner, Zhang Yizi. Now, Yan Zi is someone, she's a doubles player, and actually I've known her. She's been extremely friendly to me from the very beginning. She was the player that when I first started working with the national team, she was the one that spoke the English, so I was able to share a lot of gospel with her, and I still do. And she said something to me at the Beijing tournament last October, just a few months ago. She came up to me, and I heard her speaking in Chinese to someone who was sitting next to us. She didn't know that I could pick up enough of what she was saying that I could understand. She was telling her friend that I had given her Christian material tracts many, many years before. And she said that she carried that with her in her bag. And she said it helped her a lot. And I stopped her mid-conversation and I started speaking to her. And she spoke perfect English. And she said, yes, that's right. You did help me. Sorry, because it's close to my heart, you know, these players. So it's a sensitive thing for me to talk about that, because I've shared the gospel for 20 years with these players from China. And you know, I believe that God can do miracles there. And before, when I first went to China, no one thought that China could ever play tennis. They could never have great players, and they have great players. And I believe that God can do great and wonderful things with the people in China. So Yan Zi is someone who's special to me because she was the first player who spoke English. Pray for her. I'd like to talk a little bit too about some of the other players and so forth. You know, there's a lot of misconceptions about China. I was actually up in Beijing just recently. Sorry, I have tears coming down my eyes. But the Chinese players mean a lot to me. There's misconceptions. People say, oh, China, there's, you know, many, many people playing in China. I spoke with the China Tennis Federation, the top businessmen of China who are really running programs in China and are Chinese, the equipment manufacturers in China who are Chinese, and I saw for myself what's happening there. What's happening, the reality is there are courts. People can go there and be very blown away by the facilities, because the Chinese mentality is, let's build this huge thing to show the world. You can find a place with 50 courts, for example, beautiful courts, brand new, but you won't find anybody playing on the tennis courts. Nobody playing and using the courts. And that's the reality of China. The number of people who play in China is very small, mainly because it's not a rich place. They have people who have a lot of wealth, but they're choosing, you know, they have to compete with table tennis, badminton, volleyball, and basketball. Those are the primary sports in China. Tennis is not one of the primary sports, and probably there are less, you know, I read a report last week where there's millions of tennis players are going to start playing tennis because of Nali, and I don't think that's the case, at least in the near future. It's not one of the primary sports. The equipment is very expensive, and also majority of people do not have money. They're living month to month. And this was said to me by all the equipment manufacturers, the businessmen in China, and so forth. So while the media is promoting China as being the next world number of people who are playing tennis, right now that's not the case. And that's from someone who served China for almost 25 years in the tennis world. And I would have to say I'm one of the few, if not, there may be one or two people like me who exist. Who really know about the circumstance there. So we need to pray for China for sure, and I believe there will be an impact eventually. The equipment manufacturers have told me, like the top ones, Head, Prince, they're losing money in China hand over fist with equipment sales. They're set up, but they're not selling any equipment. So that's the reality. But while it's great what's happened with the women, the top level, I think you're going to see more and more players are putting a lot of money in the government into the women's development. Now the men, I want to talk briefly about them. I watched the men play in Beijing. I wanted to see that. I knew the top men player back in 1992, number one in Asia, as a matter of fact, Zhao Xiaoping and Pan Bing. But what happened was I wanted to see the men players today. What's their status? What I can share with you is the top men players, they will be here. They will be on the Pro Tour within the next 5 years. I'm not great at making predictions. Usually I'm wrong. But I watched these men players play the top doubles team, ATP doubles teams in Beijing and in Shanghai singles. And I can tell you this, they belong on the Pro Tennis Tour worldwide, these men, because they are good. They're very good. They can compete with the top players in the world. And I think it's just a matter of time before we get a group of men that are going to be traveling on the Pro Tour that are going to be doing very well, much like the women. It's just a matter of time. So we should be realizing that about the men's tennis. They're going to be existing on the Pro Tour. So I just wanted to bring you up to date on the China. Sorry about my breakdown with my crying, but this is something that is super sensitive to my heart because I live in China and I committed my life to Chinese people many years ago as a missionary, a Christian missionary. So that's it. And we might follow this up with another tape on Chinese tennis. I don't know. But I hope you've enjoyed this little series and it's helped educate you. Pray for the players of China, all the players. Pray for the people that are coming into China who can help the Chinese players in a spiritual way with a Christ-centered message. Thanks.